How we can say something on Friday and on Monday, New York Times had a different story. But if you were in the meeting on Friday, you know that what was said on Monday was a lie. And the lie was said by those who had an interest to make the Serbs and Slobodan Milosevic look bad, knowing that Slobodan Milosevic would not say anything about the meeting that he had Friday with an assistant secretary of state, for example. But I knew whose interest it was for them to say what they said on Monday. And when you go through the book, you'll see that's why I put many of the press releases in the press. And I said that the reporting on the Serbs in those years by the majority of the international press, they should be arrested for impersonating free press. You can only say that if you were a participant in it and can say it. Because if Slobodan Milosevic complained, or somebody else, it's unimaginable what they would write. I give you an example, just for history's sake. Remember the flyer that was shot down over Bosnia, the American flyer O'Grady? He was shot down, and then he was discovered and pulled out by the commandos of NATO or whoever rescued him, and he was given a ticker tape parade as a big hero who survived the punishment by the Serbs, not the Bosnian Serbs, the Serbs. So everybody is included, right? He was shot down over Bosnia, over Srpska, flying over somebody else's territory. He was shot down, so he was punished for being in their territory. In any event, he became a hero. And then time passed, and I convinced President Milosevic, as you see in the book, to do an interview with Time magazine. And he did the interview and answered the questions modestly and conservative tones. He was always very conservative in his words and his statements and his and when they wrote the story before they published it, the editor, as we had agreed, called me up, and I said, how is the story, because they were going to put it front page, and they did put it front page. He said he lied to us. I said, he lied to you. We did 3 hours of on record and 4 hours off the record with four members of the highest level of Time magazine, and I recorded. Nobody recorded meetings with Milosevic. I recorded the meeting in his knowledge, and in their knowledge, I told them I'm recording it because I knew something is going to trigger. In any event, I said, what did he lie to you about? He lied to us about the flyer. He said that he helped with the saving of the fly. He said he did. And also, he said that he was helpful in releasing the 400 hostages that Karadzic had gotten tied up into bridges and to telephone poles so his country would not get bombed by NATO, that he helped release them. I said, he did help. No, he said, we were told by a high-level official of the State Department that he did not. I said, why don't you call me back in an hour? So he called me back in an hour so I don't pay for the telephone call from Athens to New York. And I started reading from my notes. Mr. President, my president has asked me to go back to Washington. Why, Mr. Frazier? Because our flyer is dead. No, Mr. Frazier, your flyer is not dead. Come here. He's right there, protected by the Serbs, by our commandos, and by the Serbs in Bosnia. You sent the flyers over and sent your commandos to take them out peacefully.